Hello, my name is Isabel Bosquet-Morrow. My husband John and I attend Terre Nouvelle Church in Troy. We usually go to the 9 a.m. service. I'm a floral designer, and I thought since most of us are spending every day at home, I would present a little tutorial about how to make a centerpiece. So let's talk about what we're going to need. Some flowers, clearly, tulips. You know, I have some boxwood, so that's a terrific green because it does last. I got some hasta leaf, they're just starting to be tall enough to be used in an arrangement. Lilac green, and also I have some beautiful scented mint. Let's go back to the container. I picked one that has a foot, it's about 6 inches tall. It could be something a bit smaller if your table is not, that large, like a cooking bowl, salad bowl. We're going to need some water. We're going to need what I call magic powder. Sometimes it comes in little packages like this when you buy flowers at the supermarket. We're going to have scotch tape, a pair of shears. So first, let's clean our flowers. You're going to want to take all the little leaves. You don't want anything below the level of the water in your containers. You take your leaves out and you always recut your flowers and you cut them in an angle. So you're going to do that for every single bloom you have. Then if you have boxwood or any kind of green, you're going to do the same. You're going to take every single leaf that might end up in the water. So again, you cut your leaves and you put in water right away. That's what we call conditioning. I'm going to finish cleaning the flowers and I'll get back to you. Okay, so I guess we have all our greens and all our flowers clean now. So now that our material is ready, we can make our grid on our container. So we're going to use our regular scotch tape and we're going to put two pieces like this, and you leave a bit on the side because once we've made two like this and two like this, we're going to secure it even more going all around the rim of the containers. So again, this is way thicker than what I use usually, but we make do. So then you want to go all around the rim. Now we're going to fill it with water. We're going to add some of the powder. We already had put some of this powder in each of our little buckets, pitcher. Usually I use buckets, but here we are with little vases. And now we're ready to go. So we start with the greens. That is going to define the size of your arrangement. Again, we're making a centerpiece, so we want to be able to see over. I would not go more than 10 inches. I'm going to start with my boxwood. To keep on going with the lilac green. Mm-hmm. again, always remember you don't want to go taller than 10. Let's see. If you're not sure, or if you think in centimeters, like I still do, take your tape measure. And I'm a bit taller, so I'll take a little bit off here. Make sure all the stems are in water and not escaping you. Okay, so here we have it. I'm going to keep the hasta for the end, just as a way maybe to make a screen around the tulips. And same thing with the mint, it's going to be a little, maybe they will stick out of the orange one. We'll see how it goes. Maybe I don't use them and I just make green tea, mint tea rather. So I'm all my tulips are clean, remember. I have some that are really short. I'm going to start with them. Just to fill in. So I hope you can see how I go in and out. You don't want all your shorties in one side, you don't want all the tall ones. And you start with the short ones, but you know, if you find one that inspires you to stick out, just go with it. And if you don't like where it is, take it out and recut it and put it somewhere else. All right, this is something I'm not totally fond of because it's too regular. So you want to take it out and put it here. So if you're using more than one color, if you decide to be daring, I would recommend using three of one color and make a little grouping of it. It reads better, again, always the same concept, and it will be more pleasing to the eye in general. Hey, finally looking good. So I might even stop using all my tulips. Let's see if I can resist. It's usually something I don't achieve, but let's see how it goes. So again, I like when there is a lot of green and white, not just totally balance. Well, you want it balanced, but you want to have the colors read. I think that's how we describe it. So I think I'm going to use a bit of the hasta. So same thing, I recap them. See how it makes a little, almost like a screen to contrast with the white of the tulips. Okay, and then here's my mint. And remember, we're making a centerpiece, so we want to look from the side and make sure we don't see our scotch tape or... It's pretty good. Woohoo! Okay, we're done, as they say. Voila! So, I hope you have fun doing this. I'd love to see some of your creations. I can't wait to see all of you very soon. And I hope everybody stays healthy and well. Bye-bye!